I have no friends to wish me freedom once again. Choir will be singing all silent night, Christmas carol by candlelight. Please come home for Christmas. Please come home for Christmas. And if not Christmas, by New Year's night, friends and relations send salutations. Sure as the stars shine above, but this is Christmas. Yeah, this is Christmas, my dear. The time of year to be with the ones you love. So won't you tell me you're never more wrong. Christmas and New Year's will bind you home. There'll be no more sorrow, no grief and pain. And I'll be happy, happy once again.
Oh, Not in uniform, please place your right hand over your heart. Other guard, forward march. Color Guard, post of colors of the United States of America. Color Guard, post colors of the great state of Texas. Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. Pledge of Allegiance. Two. Color Guard, return to your ranks.
Generously sponsoring us to the Conrado Johnson Traditional Youth Ensemble and allowing us to share our gifts you have bestowed upon us. While we entertain you during a time when our world is still consumed by this devastating pandemic and civil unrest, let us still be reminded that there is still love, joy, and hope. It is a hope for our communities, our cities, our states, and our nation, United States of America.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are the Conrad O. Johnson Regional Youth Ensemble, and we are here to bring you some holiday joy. Since its inception exactly 21 years ago, we have been serving the inner city and greater Houston communities through an indelible cross-cultural program of music and STEM education. Our program celebrates the similarities of diverse cultures as opposed to our differences. We have been blessed to perform in Torrance, California and Honolulu, Hawaii to celebrate the Japanese American culture and have performed on stages in some of the most prestigious venues such as the world famous Carnegie Hall, the Lincoln Center in New York and the Kennedy Center for the Performing and Visual Arts in Washington, D.C. But from our current roster to our alumni, there is nothing like playing at home. So we ended the 2020 season with a stellar performance for the Greater Houston Convention and Visitors Bureau. And thanks to the gracious invitation of the Southern Federation of Syrian Lebanese American Club, we experienced another cross-cultural event last week by performing for them. And now we are home here at the beautiful ballroom at Bayer Place and showing you our family and friends love.
Hello, good people. I'm Jeremiah, and we began our program with songs I Remember Clifford, with Henry Lehman as our main trumpet player, and also Days of Wine and Roses with our two lead saxophonists right there, Edgar Castro on the tenor saxophone.
Thank you.
And our buddy. Now, and now for some holiday joy. Ladies and gentlemen, gents and dolls, just for you, here is My Favorite Things with soloist Edgar Castro on the tenor saxophone.
Let's go.
Henry Lehman, Armani Holmes, me, Jeremiah Davis, if you didn't know. Okay. And then we don't have Andrew, but we do have
Josiah Brown on drum.
And next, we have Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer with Joshua Mansfield, Jackson Cortez, and Armani Holmes. And then we have It's Beginning to Look a Lot Like Christmas with Henry Lehman. And me. Now, let's giddy up, giddy up, giddy up, let's go, and get on with this show, okay?
That was just so funny.
Thank you. Thank you. Hey, how you doing? My name is Malachi Shannon.
My name is Osiah Brown.
We want you to get ready for your next popular holiday songs. Ladies and gentlemen, y'all ready to feel some more holiday spirit? Well, here is.
Silverville, Edgar Castro, Bryson Porter, Silent Night, Edgar Castro, so Somewhere in My Memory, Edgar Castro, Tennessee, Jeremiah Davis, Stallone, and Andrew Romero, guitar.
But he ain't here. Ready to get this over with? Wait a minute.
Thank you. Hello. My name is Edgar Castro, and I play tenor saxophone. I am a student at Strake Jesuit College Preparatory, and I have the distinct pleasure of introducing our keynote speaker for this afternoon, Mr. Joshua Guyton. Mr. Guyton is a senior at Prairie View A&M University, majoring in mechanical engineering. Joshua participates in many organizations such as the National Society of Collegiate Scholars, president of the Root Christian Organization, and board member of the Melanin, a student-led organization which advocates for the success of African-American students. This summer, for the second year, he will serve his internship at Tororo Hydro Power Plant in Georgia, USA, which is in Reuben County, Georgia, and surrounding counties of Atlanta. After graduation, his goal is to be an engineer specializing in robotics and in the energy field. Joshua's philosophy of life is, no matter how hard life gets or how mad you are, if you want to succeed, you must always bounce back and be ready to go on and learn more. I want to follow God's plan for me and be able to serve him and help others. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming Mr. Joshua Guyton.
How are you guys doing today? I just want to thank you guys for allowing me to speak today. I was a little nervous at first, but they told me I have the whole 30 minutes, so I'll make sure to take my time. I'm just joking. I'll try not to keep you guys too long. At first, I just wanted to start off by thanking the Conrad Johnson organizations for, you know, just allowing me to speak today. I joined them in my junior year of college back in 2017, and ever since then, just being a part of this organization has really helped me, you know, in my college and just for the things that I'll carry with me in the future. Just one thing I wanted to mention is they also helped me too. They helped pay for me to go to college. I was a winner of the 2018 Miola Law Scholarship or for academic achievement, and that was one of the big things that, thank you. So I just really want to thank Miss Miola Laws and this organization because that really helped me, and it was a very big blessing for my freshman year in college. It really helped out. And so today I really just wanted to share with you guys kind of the things I learned while being a part of this organization. You know, as previously mentioned, I'm now a senior in college, and even though I chose a major outside of music, the kind of the lessons and the disciplines I learned while I was at Conrad Johnson kind of stuck with me over the years. One of the things that was kind of ingrained in me throughout being in this organization is consistency. One of the things that you'll always hear is consistency is key, and that's a very big part of this organization. You know, you'll see these the students here, you see how well they play. That's because they've practiced, you know, hours on end, weekends, countless weekends, you know, on top of their school, just practicing that they can play for you guys and just do their best. And that's just something that, you know, I've ingrained it, like that was ingrained in me by being a part of this organization that I took to college. Because while you're at college, you know, you'll have to work with many professors, many classes, many organizations. And if you're not consistent in your studies, if you're not consistent in what you're doing, then you're going to fail. You know, you can't just expect to look at, let's say, a lesson plan once, maybe twice, and then expect to get all A's. You have to be consistent with your studies. And, you know, just being a part of the Conrad Johnson organization really helped me get that consistency because, you know, first getting there, it's like you have to spend hours studying, but some, like, spending hours on hours, you know, practicing music, that was nothing new because, you know, you might spend 3 hours practicing. That's what you're going to do for those 3 hours is you're going to practice. And that kind of leads me to the next thing I want to say that the Conrad Johnson organization helped me with is just learning to manage my time. Because no matter how many hours that we practice in the Conrad Johnson organization, all of those hours are meaningful. Whether we practice for 3 hours, you know, we practice that whole 3 hours. If we practice for 5 hours, you're going to practice that whole 5 hours and get what you need. And, you know, even with all the hard work, there are also those times that you can, you know, relax and learn to balance your work and play life. You know, when you're in college, you can't work 24/7 and you can't, you know, play laze around 24/7. Everyone's giving that same 24 hours a day, but what everybody chooses to do with that 24 hours is up to them. And that's just a very big part of, like, something the Conrad Johnson organization really helped me with. So. It's just like, when you're in college, especially like a lot of these students I know are either in college or will be going to college in the coming years, and you have to learn to manage your time well. College will spend you 1,000 different ways, and you can't let just one overtake the other. And, this organization has just done so much for me in terms of just like learning to manage that time and how well that I use it. So that's another thing that I just want to really thank them for. And then another thing that kind of, that was really good with this Conrad organization is perseverance. A lot of the times you'll hear these students play, and I remember back when I was in high school, sometimes I would mess up, sometimes I might get a little bit nervous, but no matter what, those instructors were always there to push you forward. If you mess up, it's okay, keep going. You can't let those failures stop you. You can't let your nervousness stop you from, whatever you're trying to do. And so the Conrad Johnson organization was just like very big help in that, because even though I'd been playing the saxophone for like a couple of years, it was 4 years at the time when I joined them, there was still a lot that I didn't know. There were scales that I weren't as good at. There were solos that I just wasn't that well at the time. But, no matter how many mistakes I made, they were always there. And one of the key words, they would always say is like, if you ever heard like, let the kids play, just like, let them play, let them practice. Because if you don't let them make those mistakes, they're never going to get better if you always expect them to be perfect. he's like, no one's gonna be perfect, and that's one of the things I was joking with my dad. He's like, one of the mistakes I made, just wearing this plain tie. You see, I saw them in their nice red. I even saw a Santa hat. I was like, I should have wore something a little bit more festive for today. But nobody expects perfection all the time, and that's a very big, like, just seeing how accepting they were of your mistakes was something that was very helpful. Because a lot of the times in college, you'll have people who are just, they'll critique you for every little thing. I had a professor who took off a couple of points on my test because I wrote a dash like this and not like that. But it was like real crazy. But Conrad Johnson, they were very accepting of like the mistakes I made and just propelled me forward to keep going. And kind of the last thing and one of the most important lessons I learned from the Conrad Johnson organization was how you should hold yourself like when you're in public, when you're doing things, and how you should just hold yourself a standard. One of the things that I always used to hear, just like overall when I was in Conrad, was you never know who is watching. And that's a very important statement, especially when I realized when I got to college is it only takes somebody a fraction of a second to look at you and make a first impression. No matter where you go, you'll have strangers looking at you, especially in college. No matter what, it just takes a fraction of a second. Not quick enough for me to dodge out if I'm looking a mess, for them to make, whatever assumption based on how you're looking that day. And some of the things I learned when I was in the Conrad Johnson organization, it was one of my first performances where we really got dressed up. We had our suits, we had our bow tie, and we had our cummerbund. And at the time, our instructor was Mr. Portis. So at first, all the students, we got there, we arrived a little bit early, and, then we saw Mr. Portis. He walks in, he was all dressed up. He had the cufflinks, the nice bow tie, it was a nice decorated one, just looking real nice. Me and the other guys were like, Mr. Portis, you're looking real, real fly today. Like, we didn't know you could dress like this. It was the first time seeing it. And, kind of like seeing those things over and over again, that's the impression that you want to leave on people. And that's the kind of, impression that I got from the Conrad Johnson organization is just when you see these people for the first time, no matter like where you're playing, where you're going, you want to make that first impression and make it a good one because that's the only one that you're going to get. And it's just like that time management. It's like time is one of the few things that once you lose it, it's gone forever. You can't get that back. And the Conrad Johnson organization has just taught me so many things and just provided with me so much. And that's really just what I wanted to say today. I just wanted to thank them again, Miss Myola Laws, especially Miss Artie, Mr. Rollo, and Mr. Portis. They've all just been a great help for my development in college, and I'll just take these things forever because they're some of the most important lessons that I've learned. And I also just wanted to thank my parents for coming here. See my dad, he'd be giving me little hand signs to help out. He wasn't doing it right, but I just wanted to thank you, and that's kind of what I wanted to say to you guys today.
Hey, hey, hey. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Olutoyin Onayemi, and I've had the pleasure of directing these young musicians this evening. I'd also like to recognize our alumni, Mr. Jawad Muhammad. Ms. Chelsea Blackman. There she is. The guy you just got through listening to, Mr. Joshua Guyton. And do we have our artist in residence here? Is he here, Mr. Joe Carmouche? Okay, that's fine. We still recognize him, and we can recognize him again. Also, the two band directors, former band directors that we've had helping us get ready for this show and in general, Mr. Claude, where'd you guys go? Mr. Claude Robinson and Ms. Devette Robinson. Thank you. I'll say it to anyone who will listen. Mr. Robinson was the person who was where I am when I was where they are. Yes, so yeah, one of the ones, and including Mr. Johnson. So, and also Miss Elfrida Brown, who along with Mr. Robinson and several others have taken us to all those places that Henry named out at the beginning, Kennedy, Lincoln, and Carnegie. Those were the big ones. All right, and to get us going again, we have Mr. Edward Bocock. Thank you.
Good afternoon, I'm Edward Bocock. Many great jazz artists have left their mark on these next holiday treasures. No, we cannot let this joyous season pass without hearing them and feeling the holiday joy that they bring. Here is Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas, featuring Malachi Shannon on the trombone and Edgar Castro on the tenor sax. The Christmas song featuring Armani Holmes, Amari Walker, and Jeremiah Davis. And finally, Christmas Time is Here with Amari Walker, Jackson Cordes, Jeremiah Davis, Armani Holmes, Edgar Castro, and Joshua Mansfield.
Thank you.
Let the people know that they're gonna get something so they can be up here to receive it. So again, a token of our appreciation, sir.
just what he said. We need to acknowledge some people properly. And we would like to acknowledge the staff and the volunteers that work hard. We've been here 21 years, and it's predominantly a volunteer. It's a volunteer organization. And to say that we have been volunteering for these kids for 21 years is a feat. So I want the volunteers to please stand. I can't call everybody's name, but all the volunteers and staff, Dr. Wills, everybody, would y'all stand and be acknowledged. All right. And as y'all see, a lot of the volunteers are parents. And we need to acknowledge the parents because we cannot do anything without the parents. And we have some fantastic, wonderful, supportive parents. And like he said, parents and parents and parents. Exactly. We have some fantastic parents. And I would like for Victoria and Edgar Castro Sr. to stand. Because if it was not for them, because this is our normal rehearsing space. And at the end, we didn't have anything because it was booked. And so the parents had to step in and they opened up their home, beautiful home to our kids for at least five of the rehearsal dates. So that's the reason I wanted to acknowledge Victoria and Edgar. Also the Lehmans, they're also responsible for the Boy Scout Troop 505, but they also open up their home to us as well. So if Vincent and Ellen Lehman, give them a hand. It's a family affair. And then we have the sponsors, because we need a little money at least to buy equipment and supplies and music. So I would like for them to stand. Mr. and Mrs. Howard, Jerry and Donna Howard, Charles Swindell. I'm missing somebody. I always do that. But anyway, I get full because, like I said, because it's a labor of love. And then also Joshua. And y'all heard what he heard, Joshua Guyton, who is our speaker. And Joshua, what school did you say you what school do you attend, darling? Prairie View A&M University. Prairie View. Yeah. Yeah. Mechanical engineer. Thank you. I want you to meet Ingrid Walker, but from Prairie View. Okay. But I just needed to acknowledge some people. And then, of course, our students. And they've worked hard. They've worked very hard. Late at night, coming out in the weather. And still trying to maintain their grades at school and all the other things that they have to do. And it's no easy feat. So give them a hand. And you know, we are streaming live. And before I say it, one other thing, he mentioned the band directors that had been instrumental in taking us to these other places across the country. So the first was Carnegie Hall, and so I have to acknowledge Miss Alfreda Brown, because she was the band director at that time. Mr. Claude Robinson and his wife, Debette, who came back, but they also instrumental in us going to Lincoln Center. And Mr. Portis, that you heard Joshua speaking of, He's not here, but he carried us to Kennedy Center. But anyway, and then, last but not least, is my right hand and my heart. And I just appreciate him taking the rings because we need to pass it on. And that is my son, Toyin James Charlie Onayemi. So I really thank you guys for coming. Thank you, Mr. and Mrs. Howard, for driving from Galveston to come just for this show. And thank you again, Victoria and Edgar, because they postponed their trip driving to Florida just for this show. So they'll be leaving out. So again, I have to acknowledge the dedication. And then, Stephanie, this is the other half of Craig. And I want to acknowledge Stephanie Howard, for who's been so gracious for us. And then my former principal, my boss, I cannot, because she's one of the reasons I'm here, and that's Susan Soto. And her husband, Petro. Okay, I think I probably missed somebody again, but okay, thank you so much.
We wish you a Merry Christmas.
Again, thank you guys for coming out, and have a Merry Christmas. You know what? Let's do it again. One, one, two. A one, two, three, one, two. No. Go ahead and stand up, take your bow. Okay.
Alright guys, y'all go eat and then come back here.
I know it is.
You gotta rush.
great albums.
Pasar por la casa para decir chao. Yo digo chao a ti, mi perro, y te adoro.
And it was really nice from last year.